Hello everybody, welcome to Boxing Science. In this video, we're going to be taking Stephen Cairns, aka the Irish TAKEOVER, through one of his first strength and conditioning sessions here at Boxing Science. Our strength and conditioning coach, Tom Monday, is taking him through this workout, working on the basics of strength and movement, based off his results that he did a testing session just the other week. So he's been doing some short ground contact pogos, and we're just Tom has manipulated the intensity of these pogos to make sure that he's getting a shorter ground contact time to help improve his reactive strength. Then he's going to move on to some Romanian deadlifts. These are important to train that hinge pattern and strengthen the posterior chain. And then he's going on to some pressing movements. He's really strong upper body wise. So we're wanting to try and get the whole core working with the pressing movement rather than him overcompensating using them shoulders. So doing some floor press, raising legs, so it's utilizing the core. And then it's got a range of different core and single leg exercises. Again, just building up that foundational strength and movement skills to help build to future gains in the future. Future gains in the future? All right, let's start the video. Cheers.
Wicked, so we're gonna do some plyos, same as the other day. Deadlifts today, probably spend about 45 minutes on his strength work, and then we're going to do a little bit more than we did last week on the running. So we'll do five sets. Yeah, see how we go. We'll do five sets rather than four today. Good. Good. Yeah, cool. Sound. We'll go on to some ice skaters. Five each side, please, with the foot kicked behind you. Good. We're going to do some pogos now. We'll pick up from where we left off. So quick contacts, I'd like under 170 milliseconds. And then as much jump height you can get within that window. Okay? On you, pal, yeah. Good. 8, 9, 10. Stay in there. Good. Stay in that area. So brilliant. So average was 166, and you were jumping about 25.3 centimeters every time. So that's decent. So brilliant in terms of our contacts. They were all under that kind of 1.7 zone. Yeah. If you're ready and you feel good, we can just keep nudging that up. But they look really solid. They look really snappy. Well done. Good. Little breather, and then we'll go through that same round again. So that's just overloading the landing a little bit. So rather than coming in from that kind of 45 centimetre height, 50 centimetre height, you're coming in from that a little bit more now. Same stick in the landing, same again. Good, solid. Land in a position where you'd be ready to jump if you can. Yeah, good. So you don't have to do that the next three reps, but you can have that in mind. Yeah. That's cool. Like that, really good. Two more like that, please, mate. Our last set, pogo jumps. Flight time was 4.54, and contact time was 1.66. That gives us a ratio of 2.73. I've just had a look what you got on week one, which was 2.58, so that's already gone up a significant percentage, so you're producing a lot more force in a lot less time. That's going to help your footwork speed and feet defences and counter-punching off that, allowing you to transmit more energy more quickly. So that's really good. So we'll keep an eye on this now. I'm going to, can we keep this the same, and can we nudge this up a little bit higher? So if we can. So can you beat 4.54 just to nudge that ratio up even more? Nice, good. Sound, awesome. Good, that's us, innit? That was five, wasn't it? Ice skate, same again. What I'd like this set a little bit more of, like Danny picked up on it already. Rather than there, can you be there? That shoulder rotation was brilliant. Like, you kept everything in line, so keep that going. And then add that, and then we'll be on to a real winner there. So hips back towards that box a little bit more. Good, hips back a little bit more. Lean your chest forward. That's it, good, better. I'm going to get you to warm up with, do you remember that same drill from last week where we're learning to hip hinge? If you do, for me, two sets of eight, yeah, with broomstick, I'll give you that, mate, and then over near the squat rack, Two sets of eight, please. Yeah, that's the one, yeah. Same again, because you did pretty good at that last week. Sound, yeah, work that thing down. We'll go straight onto them, mate. So your deadlifts from last week, like eight reps, please. So, same again. One thing Danny had you working on was, and we were really going after was hips in and under. So squeezing your glutes right the way through the bar and having that as the main driver. Superb, good. Good, look at the bottom corner of the room. Now just let your hips travel a bit more. That's better, awesome. Best rep yet, superb. Brilliant. Nice, man. Bring your toes back into your shin. Yeah, other than that, brilliant. Cool. Nice, pal. What do you reckon, 60? Do you want to try 60? Sound. We finished on 50 last week. Let's see what 60 looks like, and then. So much better than last week. Really, with more weight as well. Really good, really good. We'll do them dead bugs, and I'll just. I've no comments, but I'll just show you the phone. You can have a watch of it back. Let's do 65 today. So it looks well comfortable, but I'm more bothered about like just not putting too much weight on too quick compared to last week. So. Good, really good, really good. I thought there was like a slight drop in, but obviously that's just because it's getting heavy, and it's just like weights that are challenging a little bit. But yeah, other than that, brilliant. Well done, mate. Good. You just your dead bugs, and then we'll move it on. Nice, exploding, man. Good. Little pause at the bottom if you can. Nice, good. Yeah, no comments, just good, man, really good. We'll go over there, TRX, oh yeah. Awesome, yeah, great job. I'm doing a really good job of getting the shoulders back. That seems to be freeing up a little bit, getting it a little bit easier as well. So, what do you reckon? Should we go 27s on them? Try that, yeah. I thought they looked explosive and solid, so. In step right up against that, you can use the one to steady it. You're gonna be there. Drop the back knee till it nearly touches the floor. And then come back through. Let's go. Let's do eight each side, please. Okay, no, we'll get rid of that because that was cool. Next on these, let's do 20. Slight, just to make it a little bit easier for you. I need to come taller, quicker now. So stand up taller rather than staying low and going forward. Can you be here? So you're almost going diagonal up. Other than that, it's bang on alignment, everything, what the things we were working on last week were really cool. So we'll do 20, mate. We're doing 15s on these last week, so we'll go 20 today. Awesome, great work, sound. Yeah, on to them, mate. Just look forward this time. Now you've obviously got that as a reference, but look forward this time. Just try and really squeeze your shoulders back. Oh my God. Just lift up a little bit, pal. There you go. Three, two, one, time. So, a little breather, and then we'll go again. Good. See if we can keep your shoulders back as well. That's it. So, arms move out. Yeah, good. Cool. Ever so slightly lifting that right shoulder up to keep it below my hand. There you go. Yeah, better. Sound. Yeah, good. Like, about half a centimetre, like barely. Better, like, I'm being so picky, but yeah, no, it's good.